superhero. I'm talking bulletproof, kind of suit. Reflect the struggle that they put us through. With the strength to fight the power like Chuck D a do. With the insight to be equal. No, the skies needed a voice that finds reason to multiply people in the streets for the cause. Marching on Washington, might as well be walking through walls. Type of superhero show up when ain't no one to call. Better shield you from them shields that been killing us all. High beams for eyes to peek, the villains in the dark. Power of resolution for a war would even start. The knowledge to build and grow where they live. And take care of the kids and the older folk. The clean cause they need it most. Politic with the kings. About economic growth, cure PTSD. Cause mental health ain't a joke. Feed the hungry and dope. Everyone would know, everywhere we go.
Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Need a black superhero. Every block, every hood, every city, every ghetto. Need a black superhero.
Pleased as always to be bringing you coverage of the National Football League on EA Sports. Today we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here between the Denver Broncos and the Jacksonville Jaguars. Toward the midway point of this NFL season, and we're underway on EA Sports. Fielded right around the 8. And not a good return at all. Down inside the 10, all the way back at the 7.
That return, it will not be on the postseason highlight reel. If you're the offensive coordinator, you've just changed your play calling because you thought you might have some field to work with. Instead, now, you've got to call plays that won't make mistakes.
Ready? Check, check.
Now ETN to start the drive. And they'll get him down up past the 15. A good start. One play, 10 yards. Well, there you go. This offense off to a strong start this afternoon.
Yeah, with a big run and a first down. That's putting what you practice into play. That's excellent execution to get things started.
On first down, right back to ETN. And he is going to lose yardage here. So a step in the wrong direction. Now they'll look to make amends on second and 14. Looking to throw, Lawrence. He'll get this one complete to Zay Jones. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. That one covers 29 yards, first down.
Quarterbacks love slant routes because the receivers are breaking right into their line of vision. And receivers love them as well because they're getting the ball on the move and able to catch it and try and get upfield and gain additional yardage.
Ready, ready.
On first and 10, it's ETN. And he'll lose yardage here, back at the 41. He'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Here's Lawrence to throw. Open man right side is Ingram. And he'll be tackled on the other side of midfield at the 46-yard line. To a first and 10 now in Denver territory at the 46. ETN up the middle. And he picks up about 6 as he gets this down to the 41. The Jaguars now at 2-5 to start play. And they were winners their last time out, so they'll be looking to make it 2 in a row.
And so much about football, partner, comes down to mindset. Being in the right frame of mind, and the best way to get in that good frame of mind, winning. So they come in feeling good. They've got the home crowd behind them. I think they're going to be tough to beat in this one.
And here he'll be brought down a little shy of the 35 at the 36. So from the 36 now, first and 10. Lawrence, now this is ETN on the draw. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. Counting down toward the midway point in quarter one. On second and 12, Lawrence. Into double coverage, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Simmons. And the Broncos are going to get the football here as they force the INT on the game's opening drive. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10. Just shy of midfield at the 49. And they go backwards here, losing yardage back at the 48-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Well, this defense for the Jaguars, they were very strong in the win last week over the Giants.
And no matter what's done throughout a ball game, it always comes back to blocking and tackling. That's the essence of football. But I think it's hard for people to understand just how difficult it is to tackle, especially open field. Very few missed tackles.
And this throw will be intercepted. Picked by Riley Harrison. And he'll return this ball across midfield to the 47-yard line. So a first interception thrown for him there. And that really not the best decision either.
Not at all. And that's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game. But this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake. Now let's see if they're going to turn it into points.
On second down, ETN once more. And he's going to be met at about the 43. And the line to gain here is the 37 on third down. Now Lawrence. Right side, it's Manhertz, the tight end. And they'll get him down about 3 yards short of the first. And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And that's going to make it fourth down.
Excellent job there defensively. Gave up the underneath to the tight end on third down, and they made sure that they did their job. Got him on the ground and prevented him picking up a first down.
And I don't think this has the carry. It does not. It's no good, and this will remain a scoreless game.
Well, Brandon, anything beyond 50, you start rolling the dice a bit. And once you get up around 57, 58 yards, the chances of making it go down dramatically. And sure enough, this one winds up no good.
They'll begin the drive with Hunt. And a loose football. And the Jags grab it. And the possession is theirs at their own 40.
The start of this game has me doing flashbacks and remembering when I was playing and seeing a similar start and seeing the head coach actually take a timeout and gather the whole team around him and tell everybody to get it together. Let's get some focus going here because maybe he just sensed that maybe this the whole team wasn't ready to play.
Yeah, well, they've gone interception, now fumble. On second and 12, Lawrence. And seeing nowhere to throw, he chucks this one away from harm. Incomplete. Now it's third down.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play. And he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
And fights him off. But he can't get away forever, and down he goes. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. On fourth down, on is Logan Cook to punt. It's taken to the 26. A 40-yard punt, given 3 on the return. And the Broncos take over, first down and 10. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And they come into this one riding that nice long win streak. And remember, next weekend is an open week for them. So if they can get the win here, a lot of momentum into that time off.
It certainly is. And if you're wondering if anybody's saying, boy, this is coming at a bad time, we want to keep playing, the answer can be yes, because when teams are on a hot streak, they want to keep going. But what the veterans are telling the young guys in the locker room, an open week is always good, guys. Take it and let's go with it.
To throw once more on second and 10. Wilson. And that'll be incomplete. Took a pretty good shot as he tried to pull that one in. Couldn't hang on. Third down.
Against a team coming off a win, just as your team did the previous week, you talk about being physical all game long. Sometimes being physical is just being on the spot and helping force the incompletion. 36 power.
Play action. It's Wilson. That's complete. It's Okwuegbunam. And he's going to be out up around the 45-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 16 and a Bronco first down. No score after one on EA Sports. First down, they'll run with Hunt. And he'll be brought down at the 50 after a gain of about five. Now this game, the night that the Jags have played here in London, you might know that Shad Khan, he's the owner of both the Jaguars and Fulham in the English Premier League on the soccer side of things. And this is the third of three London games the NFL will play this year. But there is one more game to come over on the continent, the Seahawks and Bucks from Munich, Germany. The first time a regular season game will be played there. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. A quick throw caught out wide by Judy. No gain on the play, and that's going to bring up second down.
That was a simple throw and catch, but even with that completion, 0 yards gained, so they're behind schedule on down and distance.
I think they were hoping to get it to him. He could make a man or two miss, but that window closed quickly. Flushed out right. And he wisely will throw that one away.
And he's only hit on two of his first six passes. Time for a quick quarterback regroup here with a big third down coming up.
Here comes the eighth play of the drive, and they need a full 10 yards on third down.
Hey, zero. Run left.
Hand off up the middle, Hunt. And he can only manage to take the football to the 40, and that is well shy of the first down marker. So coming on now is the field goal unit. They're going to try for three, and he'll need all the leg he's got here. They'll spot it at the 47, so call it a 57-yard attempt. And that is no good. He gave it a good run. That wasn't more than a foot or so wide to the left. And this will remain a scoreless game. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. We sort of suspected that the elements might wreak havoc on both of these offenses, and that's been the case. No points on either side as this drive begins with a first down.
Oh, it's time to give a little credit there to the defense. They played that very well because it was a drag route, and he ran a little shallower than normal as he worked straight across the field. He was hoping he'd get lost behind the defensive line, but once he made the catch, nowhere to turn upfield and gain any yardage.
And he still has yet to get on track in this first half as they're going to stop him behind the line. So 7 yards from the first down here as they come up to the line of scrimmage. From midfield now, Lawrence. Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Problems on third down so far in this first half. Relatively small sample size, but they're now 0-for-3.
And the average in the league, somewhere around 40% on third down for offenses. So what's the answer to this? Either convert them or don't get the third down in the first place. Get your big chunks of yards on first and second down.
And that hits at the 6 and carries into the end zone for a touchback. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. sitting in first place in the division. They've got an open date on the calendar coming up next week. So, Charles, you and I were talking about this before the game. This one for them kind of has some extra importance.
It certainly does, because if they can get the win here and pad their lead a bit or at least keep pace, then they can really kick their feet up and say a job well done at this point and not have to worry about ball at all until they're back in their facility, back in their meeting room, getting ready for the next game.
Man open, he's got it complete to Cortland Sutton. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. And not a whole lot of room to operate there on the first down run. He gets maybe three. The last run got three, now here's second and seven. They go play action now. Wilson sliding out of the pocket. He finds Sutton crossing the formation complete. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48. This offense finding its legs now. Here's another first and 10. Hunt will try going up the middle. Oh, he's got a little daylight. The 20. And they will finally catch him, but not before he reaches the 8-yard line. 57 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. We've seen him break off a big run already in this game, and for a second, that one looked like it might be another.
Yeah, I think that any defense would say, look, we can't let him get to the second level, because sometimes he'll break off the big run on his own, but oftentimes you get additional blocking at the second level, which gets you deeper into the secondary.
Time the yards won't come so easy as they'll in fact tackle him behind the line. They'll run with Hunt on second down. And running room hard to come by here. He gets it down to the 8. A big play forthcoming. Here's third and goal. Play action. Now Wilson. And he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game. Fourth down, Wilson trots off, and on comes Brandon McManus for the Denver field goal. From the left hash, it's a 36-yard attempt. The kick by McManus is good. And we have action on the scoreboard just before halftime. It's 3-0. So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks at tables end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
A fairly short kick from the 14. And they're going to start this drive in pretty good shape as they get it up past the 30. So holding will scratch off some of that return.
And I know fans get frustrated when they see penalties of this sort on kick returns, but it is difficult to do it right against these moving targets at full speed. Hard to do.
And he's got room. Touchdown, Jaguars. Travis Etienne, as the first half is winding down. And the Jaguars have taken the lead here in the final stages of this first half. A good hold in these wet conditions. The point after is up and good, and that makes it a 7-3 lead. So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away. This one fielded at the 5. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And with time quickly fading here in the second quarter, not sure how aggressively offensively they want to play this.
I think we'll find out just how much they trust their guys in this situation if they decide to take a shot.
Once again, they'll go from the 23-yard line on second and 10. Wilson now off the bootleg. And a big loss here as he's taken down. And now they'll take a timeout defensively. After the second down play, they burn the timeout, making him sweat out the final few ticks here in the second quarter. Well, the white flag coming out as they line up to kneel on it. And they take a knee. And they're going to take a timeout defensively. So with fourth down coming up, they go ahead and burn it and say we'll see what happens. The Broncos send out their punter now as his first punt will come from inside his own end zone. So we've reached intermission here in a low-scoring game. 7-3 is our score. As it's time now to send you back stateside to Orlando, Florida, and check in with Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach. And we welcome you back live now inside the booth alongside Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon, set and ready to rock for the third quarter. As they say here in London, all to play for as we are back underway in the second half. This taken in at the goal line. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive.
But Charles, we saw a pretty entertaining first half, close ball game. Remember there toward the end of the second quarter, the opposition scored to take the lead. Now we'll see if these guys can get a score of their own to regain that lead.
Yeah, they want to have that type of a response, don't they? Because they want to find a way to take control of this ball game one more time. Gauntlet's been thrown down. They want to see if they're ready to answer it.
Off the play fake, here's Wilson. He'll get that complete to Albert O. And he'll have it past midfield almost to the 40 before being taken down. 23 yards the pickup there. So in Jacksonville territory now. Here's a first and 10 at the 42-yard line. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And very little there. He might have gotten a yard. Yeah, I think he got a yard to the 41.
Yeah, things were pretty stacked up there in the middle of the line. A lot of bodies, not much space. I think ultimately he was fortunate to get anything out of that run.
They go play action with Wilson. And that'll fall incomplete. He was hit just as he let that go. And now it's third down.
The goal is certainly to try and make a big play happen and climb back into this game, but you have to be careful. If you overdo it, you could turn it over and hurt your team.
On third down, Wilson. Throw left side complete. That's Hunt. And he will have a Broncos first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Throwing now, Wilson on first down. On the shuffle pass, and it's complete. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. That one unable to develop, never got going. A loss of a couple, and it's second down. Again, Wilson. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hunt. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. This will be play number 8 here on the drive. It's third and a yard. They'll try to run for it. And he loses the football a second time.
Wow, that ball is not free. But a teammate comes along and scoops it up. Almost like, it's almost like baseball. Guys at bat, people are on base in scoring position. One guy doesn't get him home. The next guy comes through and picks him up.
And avoids the turnover. And they work this near the 5. He'll be stopped at the 6. 2 catches in the first half. Now he's got a third here, and it's good for a first. Wilson. It's incomplete.
His impatience has to be bubbling over, trying to find a way to get his team to the end zone for the first time. He did find a way to break contain and get outside to buy his receivers a little extra time, but the connection couldn't be made on that throw.
On second and goal, Wilson. This one complete to his fullback out of the backfield. 5 yards that time on the completion, and now it's third and goal.
35.
Hunt. And Hunt is not going to get there. They run for it with Hunt. And I don't think he got in. He didn't. He stoned at the 1 yard line. Hunt is unable to get in on fourth and goal. And the Jaguars are able to come up with a goal line stand. And they've now made two trips to the red zone and still looking for their first touchdown.
Not able to punch it in, and if you're on defense, your confidence is sky high. Because mentally, you're saying, hey, if you're in the red zone, we're thinking we're giving up three. We just want to give up six. In this case, they end up not giving up the touchdown at all. They've got to feel great about what they got done.
And he maneuvers up the middle for three, and it's second down. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
On second down, Etienne once more. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone, they need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Lawrence from his end zone. They'll complete this to Ingram as tight end. And he'll go out of bounds just shy of the 20. 17 yards is the pickup there for number 17.
And I feel a little bit like a traitor as a former defender because that big man did not want to go down and refused to go down. If you're a defender and you don't get the right angle on a big tight end like him, he can run right through you like you're not even there. And he did a lot of that on that play.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. ETN once more. And he'll fight forward to about the 27-yard line. Still a couple yards short of the first as the three-yard gain brings up a third down.
So where'd all that running room that he had in the first half go? Because it looks like it's drying up a little bit here. Someone made some adjustments, it appears, at least on this drive.
They'll run with Etienne, and he picks up the first before he's taken down at the 29. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. Well, they gave themselves options there on the third down play and were able to convert on that RPO.
Shows a lot of trust with the guy taking the snap, doesn't it? Because you're counting on him to make the right reads and give the ball where it's supposed to go. And he did on that play.
Boy, the run on first down, a disaster as he's tackled well behind the line of scrimmage. Three quarters in the books. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. So a 5 yard run the other way in the wrong direction, and that leads us to second and 15. Running out of the gun with Etienne. And he's upended after a gain of two out to the 27. Ninth play of the drive coming up, and certainly not an easy one on third and long. Lawrence will throw. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Ronald Darby. So the penalty on the offense, no need to accept that. They'll decline it, and the interception will stand. First and 10, and they've got three tight ends out there. A jumbo package look. Now it's Wilson.
And he will find his man Sutton. That's complete. Touchdown! Courtland Sutton, his fifth touchdown now on the year. And the Broncos have moved out in front here in the fourth quarter. Extra point from McManus is good. And the lead is now 10-7. After the touchdown, here's McManus now to kick it away. Taken at the 15, a short kick. And he brings us out past the 20 to the 24. Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And they will be looking to answer the touchdown their defense just surrendered. Still a good chunk of time remaining here in the fourth quarter and a chance to regain the lead in a tight one. Well, that's the third interception for Lawrence. Picked off by Jeff. So from the 36 now, first and 10. After the interception, here's Wilson. And he gets it down a yard or two shy of the 30 before he's out of bounds. The improv on the scramble there gets him six, and it'll be second down. They'll run with Hunt. Shreds him with a stiff arm. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. 79 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. They run again with Hunt. And a good gain here of 9 from the 19 down to the 10.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball?
And this offense on third down today, lacking much success, just 2 for 7 to this point. Here it's 3rd and 3. Just a yard on the run there, and that's going to bring us to a fourth down. Well, with the fumble he had earlier, we know how key keeping the football is here. That fumble earlier, probably at the forefront of his mind. Just hold on to this thing.
It's also at the forefront of the mind of the guys who are trying to get the ball from him. And since they've seen him drop it on the ground before, they're doing everything possible to have him do it again. They need that turnover.
The kick by McManus is good. And the lead stretches to 6 here. It's 13-7.
So that gets him a little bit of breathing room, but not much. And you have to think back to the field goal that he missed earlier. This would be a 2-score game right now if he had converted then.
And if you and I are thinking about it, you know he is as well, because in the back of his mind, he's thinking, hope I get one more shot in an important spot. He just made that one. He wants one more later to truly make up for the earlier miss.
Jaguars come to the line to start their next drive. And that last turnover could have proven more costly, but their defense only gave up 3. But now answering with a field goal doesn't do them much on this drive. They need to try and find the end zone. Yikes, a 4-yard loss really sets them back now for second down.
Yeah, another negative play in an early down situation. This one to start the drive. You're putting a lot of pressure on your quarterback to bail you out when you're in second and long yardage.
On second down, ETN once more. And he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Boy, where would these guys be without his performance on the ground? That puts him over 100 yards now for the afternoon, and I tell you, he seems to be getting stronger as the day goes along.
The Jaguars going to go ahead and use their first timeout. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. This is third and two, maybe the biggest play in this football game. Another toe-free TN. No gain on the play there, and it'll bring up fourth down. Here we go, gotta have it. Lawrence, it's complete, swings it out to his running back. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage. On first and 10, it's ETN. They'll lose a yard there, and it's second and 11. Lawrence. That's complete to Travis Etienne out of the backfield. Yeah, he's going to be out of bounds, but not before he takes it inside the 40. 16 yards that time on the pickup for the Jags and a first down.
And here we are in the fourth quarter, partner, and watch them drive for what would be a go-ahead touchdown. And you and I both know this is where you need a quarterback who can keep his cool back there, not just for himself, but to keep the rest of the team relaxed too.
3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and 7. Someone moved. Flag is out. That's going to be 5 yards.
And that'll drive coaches crazy. You work all week on dealing with loud crowds, on dealing with motion, and then you have a guy jump.
And that false start penalty certainly not helping their cause here. Second down and long. Now Lawrence to throw. Eluding the pressure right. And he's going to find his man out of the backfield. That's complete. And this is going to be another first down as they'll make the tackle at the Broncos' 13-yard line. A shotgun snap and a give to ETN. And now they're inside the 10 as he's brought down at the 9. 9-yard line, second and 6. Throwing now, Lawrence. Finds his tight end, Ingram. And from the 9, they get this to the 5-yard line. They'll come to the line, needing only 2 yards to gain the first here. On third down, here's ETN. Well, they hit him in the backfield, and he will not escape. And that is not going to get it done. They're going on fourth down. Lawrence. And they will touch him down, but not before he gets the first. Just a gain of 3, but they'll certainly take it as they convert on fourth down. They come up on a first and goal and most likely 4-down territory as they need a touchdown and a PAT for the lead. And they'll run with ETN. And they'll get him down just shy of the goal line at about the 1. Now the Broncos are going to call the first of their timeouts. It's just their first. They've got 2 more to use here in the final stages. Second and goal from the 1. One more time with ETN. And he is in as they have tied it late here in the final minute of the fourth quarter. The dramatic score to tie it, and now they just need the PAT to get the lead late fourth quarter.
So much for the touchdown maker. It's all about the extra point attempter. And I can't wait to see how this one turns out.
And it's no good. He missed it. And the game remains tied. Oh, boy. Square now at 13-all as he sends this one away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Broncos onto the field, ready to start their next drive. And Charles, obviously not much time left. I'm curious to see if there's enough for them to get into field goal range and try to win this thing.
And part of you and I both know the safe calls to kneel and just take it into overtime. But it's also very tough to pass up a chance to win it right now as well. But remember, if you do attempt that, it's got to be a big play downfield and still leave yourself enough time to get your field goal unit out there and kick for the win.
Throwing now is Wilson. Finding Sutton, and he'll have a quick first down here as he gets out of bounds to stop the clock. A new set of downs after a strong pickup of 16 yards.
And partner, in a tie game in the fourth quarter, you and I both know in the NFL, that's when you lean on your stars, and he came through with a nice catch right there.
Here's Wilson. He's got his 6'5 receiver. That's Tim Patrick. And the clock will now stop as a timeout is called with 5 seconds left.
Well, we can talk about it like it's just a basic route, but how about the timing on this one? Lined up on the right, runs a deep in route, and how about the throw? Right on the money. Bam! Puts it right in there and on his hands. Nice completion. Really good pickup.
And this is right down the middle as he puts it through. And it's celebration time on that sideline as they have taken the lead in the final seconds. So in a driving rain, he steps up, puts it through just like he's practicing in a gym somewhere.
How about that? Any little slip in this weather is going to throw him off. He stepped up there like it was perfect conditions, took dead aim, and knocked it through.
They'll start this drive out on the ground. And he'll be taken down here, and that is how this one is going to come to an end. Well, it took us until the final play, Charles, to officially decide a winner, although on that last play they were so backed up it would have taken a miracle and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.
So for the Broncos, they pick up win number 7 on the year. And now it's off to Heathrow as they get set to fly back to the U.S. in a couple hours. Meanwhile, for Jacksonville, the struggles intensify as they drop to 2-6 now on the year. And they'll get a chance to redeem themselves at home next week.